I'm Vanessa Kwan. I'm a curator here at Grunt Gallery. I'm here with Dominique Petrin, who's installing her show right now, You Won't Solve the Problem with an Air Freshener. So Dominique, as you will see in the video, is very much in the installation mode, but we are taking some time out to ask a few questions and talk a little bit about the work. So my first question is a bit about your process. So can you talk a little bit about how you get from your initial ideas into full-blown installation like this?
I have two different ways of working. An artist run center, which is more like a lab situation where you experiment, explore. I come up with a bunch of material that I lay on the floor and then I develop my installation. So basically all that is here is completely improvised. I just gather information. So I would gather, like, what I mean by information would be pattern, images, or things, but kind of randomly in a way. Like, I kind of make an ensemble of patterns and objects that I print. Like, I print a pattern, and then that leads to another pattern, and another pattern, and another pattern. It's like, oh, what about this object? So it kind of, like, while printing the materials, then the ideas come.
So I wanted to ask you a little bit about some of the specifics around this installation. We have a couple of these mandalas, and I know recently you started incorporating different kinds of textile designs. Yeah. Can you talk a little bit about these forms?
Well, on my last show at my art gallery, Antoinette Esquivel in Montreal, I worked in pieces. I worked on a series of 10 quilts. We were a team of 4 women, so we gathered around. So we kind of cut in the shapes, we made the templates and everything, we assembled it, but through that shared labor, it became kind of a sharing experience of, like, our personal knowledge, like, cultural, and it kind of became like this kind of a growing, like, true work. Like, the context was this work, making these art objects, but actually the labor that we generated was a form of healing labor, and it kind of resulted in a way in the performance of making a quilt. I don't know, it made me reflect on my art practice as an artist. How do I generate labor as an artist? How, if I'm hiring an assistant and I'm producing work, what's the relationship I want? Like, how do I want it to function? So the quilting really interested me for its the labor, the idea of labor behind it.
I know that you started out doing posters and also performing, you were a musician. And so how did those two things, like this performance practice and then this silk screening process, come together and create what we're looking at now?
I have a pretty unusual path. Like, I'm a self-taught artist, I didn't go to art school really. It's a bunch of factors that came up together, like experiences that I started from zine and then slowly got into painting, and then I added some, like, repetition elements, so I started to silk screen print, but at the same time I was working in a company where I was bill posting, advertisement for cultural events, and I was already using the glue at the time. And then I got somehow involved with a band as a singer, but kind of by accidental, like, someone was gone and I ended up being the singer, and then our band got really famous and we toured all over the world.
One of the things about your work that I'm always kind of amazed by is there's this incredible, like, joyousness.
Yeah. But it's kind of angry. It's kind of angry and kind of, like, you know, it's like, well, you would go out with your best friend that you like to nag at a party and will drop, like, a full bottle of Tabasco in this drink. Like, it's like, it's kind of joyful, but it's kind of like, it's kind of mean a little bit too. It's not fully, it's joyful and full of, it's joyful for sure, but it's kind of a charged one.
What have you seen when people come in these spaces? How do they react to
these? No, but first Nick Refresher is like this becomes a selfie central. We're like, Yeah, sure, I understand why. But it's, I think people get destabilized physically first, because this is a virtual space. That's a spectacle, but it's also a performance in virtual, like the way it's layered, like these windows and the, like there's something where cognitively your mind is kind of like, ooh, like what's up, what's down, what's right, what's, this is already destabilizing. What I'm doing with that is like I'm trying to find kind of design an architecture of virtuality. So what would be to be actually physically in a virtual space?